Okay, can you believe I just spent 5 minutes trying to find a quarter inch cable? It is chaos here. It is Wednesday night, the night before Winter NAMM here in California, January 2020. My wife is walking around upstairs. You can probably hear that in the microphone. My wife, Chelsea, is walking around upstairs. She's not the softest walker in the world. I found that out from being down here in my studio. I give her a hard time about it. But yeah, it's been hectic the last 2 days, very successful days in the studio with Bob making the new record. Was fraught with danger in places, technical hiccups here and there in the studio and overcoming a bunch of stuff. But in the end, it worked out fantastic and we ended up tracking 11 songs in what only ended up being kind of slightly less than a day and a half, because we had kind of 6 hours of technical issues on day one of two. So I'm really happy that we got it all in and managed to track 11 songs. So I've been off the radar from the podcast for a few days, and I wanted to sneak one in. I wanted to sneak some practice in before I go to NAMM tomorrow. So I'm trying to be super disciplined. What is it? It's 10:05 at night here. I'm gonna do the super early run down to Anaheim in the morning, 6:30 in the morning or something like that, trying to avoid some horrific Southern California traffic. But I'm trying to be super disciplined. Like, it's all a little ghetto. These strings are so beyond dead after thrashing them for 2 days, all day long in the studio. For anyone interested, I played this bass, the 5-string Matheson single cut. I played the 4-string Matheson, and I played a little of the Zakrevsky fretless. I think a little bit of the Japanese Fender jazz bass. So I took 4 basses to the studio with me. And I played some Moog as well. I played some synth bass, which was very, very fun. I wish I could play you clips of it now, but we're not putting out any of this music right away. Gonna finish it all first. And if you are in Europe, in about 6 weeks time, we'll be there for 2.5 weeks touring, playing this new music, and there will be physical CDs available in Europe quite a long time before the record actually comes out worldwide. So check my tour schedule, Bob Reynolds tour schedule. We're coming to Italy, Germany, Czech Republic, Spain, bunch of places. So come and check out the band. It was really, really fun to be in the studio for 2 days doing that. Now edit, overdubs, some production, mixing, mastering, and we have a finish date for February 2nd. It's a really fast turnaround. And I want to kind of see how I'm feeling after 2 days of playing in the studio. I was producing the record as well, so there was actually a lot more kind of talking and directing and arranging stuff going on. It wasn't just solid playing all day. So I really do really want to check in with my chops. And maybe when I'm done, I should have done this before I started filming the podcast, but when I'm done, I'll probably change some strings right before I go to bed. Isn't that what everyone does right before they go to bed? A quick string change, brush your teeth. Right, pretty standard. Bass player, night in. And it's funny, you know, you go away and do a bunch of completely different stuff, you know, being in the studio working on somebody else's music or somebody else's project, rather. It was a lot of my music. And then you kind of get away from what you've been working on for a week or sometimes more beforehand. My technique is not good right around there. Putting too much tension in the fingers and I end up pulling the top string off the neck. So I need to be more relaxed. The old Cannonball Adderley lick. Kind of. So I probably only have 20 minutes or so here. Short one tonight. And the chaos of NAMM will no doubt mean no practicing, no matter how. I mean, I really want to be disciplined tonight and practice. Which is why I'm recording this now. Kind of forcing myself to do it a little bit just to see if I find something and stay loose. But NAMM will probably prevent me from being able to do any of that for the rest of the week. No pedals even. My pedal board is still in the bag, just straight into the amp. Let's go back to the basics. Ooh. It's really trying to be good with my sleep, but didn't get to bed until probably 2:30 last night. Super long day in the studio. Hoping to go like a nice solid 7 hours tonight. It sounds silly. I don't know whether who is out there like knows about sleep or is into that or cares about that. Maybe you're listening thinking, oh, what the hell is he doing talking about sleep? Like why bass podcast sleep? What the fuck basically? But oh, it's really important. And I notice it, the relaxation, I notice it with probably less tension in my fingers when I'm more rested, kind of more in touch with my body, and just not fatigued and lethargic, you know? You know, it's quadruply important when I travel, or when any of us travel, and 10 times more difficult to facilitate as well. Also, probably should have mentioned this a little earlier on. I've just added the physical books on Amazon. We've now figured out how to discount stuff on Amazon whenever I want. So for the book of the month, the new looping book, Bass Player's Guide to Looping, is also 50% off on Amazon now. It's $20 instead of $40. Still comes with the 2.5 hours of video. And you can go get that at Amazon.com. The whole month of January for our new book of the month promotion. One book per month will be discounted by 50%. This month, January 2020, it's Bass Player's Guide to Looping. Wish I had my loop pedal set up so I could actually do something relevant and play a loop right now, but I do not. It's all packed and ready to go to NAMM tomorrow. Nice. Oh, because I'm an idiot. There we go. Bad. I feel like I'm close to being okay. I guess that's the kind of, if I was a teacher, that's the kind of grade I'd give myself right now. Probably a B minus. I'd justify that to myself by saying, yeah, okay, been a stressful couple of days. And some music that looked kind of simple on the face of things. Like if you saw some of this music written down, you think, oh, okay, yeah, I can read that down and no problem. That'll take, you know, 40 minutes to cut. No problem. You know, you're there 3 hours later, like really figuring out the details of it. Kind of kicks you in the ass when you least expect it. So we had a few of those moments. Yeah, come on. I haven't done this one in a while. You think? Yeah. Okay. I should do the major and the minor back to back in each key. Where is it? There it is. Whoops. Planet. Sting. Wow. Okay. Probably get a copyright strike for that one fragment. Amazing. Last episode I played Your Secret Lover, and I got an email immediately as I uploaded. I got an email from YouTube saying, yep, copyright claim is my music. Son of a bitch. What was that? Oh, yeah. So it is NAMM week, like I mentioned before. It would be great if anyone listening, posted questions about NAMM. Like if you're maybe not from here, maybe you've never been to NAMM, maybe you always wanted to go, or you have questions about it, drop me a comment below the video on YouTube and leave a question, leave a comment, let me know. Chelsea and I are going to be there several days this week. I'll try and answer some of the questions here on the practice room, and we will do a post-NAMM two bass hit episode. And Chelsea and I will attempt to answer all your questions about NAMM there as well. Don't forget, practice room merch. Don't worry, I wash this. I don't just wear the same clothes all the time, but it is damn comfortable, and it is freezing in California right now. For California, it's in the low 40s, high 30s tonight, I believe. My dog is like, I do not want to go outside tonight. I don't know why I picture him with that accent. I have to work on his accent. Get that one. Getting a little sloppy now. Thank you. my harmonizer pedal. Alright, I think that's about as much useful work. If that was useful, I don't know. We'll see. Time will tell. It was good to check in with the technique and see that everything was working okay after yesterday. And just maintain that consistency. That's what this is all about. Forgive me for sounding like a broken record, but the concept doesn't change. Time spent with the instrument is kind of priceless. Got to do the work. It's like you got to do the work if you want to do the work. That isn't meant to be some profound statement. It's just a funky way of saying, like, you have to do the work, like, put in the time with the instrument if you want to go out and play and work, you know, do the work, do the real work out on the bandstand. It's been a really long time also since I went in the studio and made a record and then super quickly went out on the road with the same, exactly the same band and exactly the same music to tour that record. Been a while since I did that. Done that a few times with pop stuff, a few times with jazz stuff, but it's definitely been a while, so that is exciting. Don't forget to check the tour dates below this video. We are, like I said, Stuttgart, Berlin, Munich, Cologne, a couple of days in Sardinia, Rome, Prague, Madrid, bunch of stuff coming up in Europe. If you are in Vancouver, I think I play the 21st of February with Benny Greb, Moving Parts, at the Drumeo Festival. I think that's in the Vancouver Playhouse, if I'm not mistaken. But again, all the dates are on my website. Check out the Practice Room merch at Teespring or links directly below the YouTube video. And don't forget, questions and comments, always, always, always welcome. Love to see that. Love to hear what you guys are thinking, what you guys are feeling, your questions, all that good stuff. And Bass Player's Guide to Looping on sale, 50% off Amazon and at my store all month. This month, January 2020, is our Book of the Month promotion. So yeah, thanks for sticking with me on this kind of short one, sneaking one in here, just a little maintenance session, as is often the case late night on a busy week. And catch you guys and gals on the next one.